Midjourney recently got a major upgrade. There's a new Omni Reference feature that lets you put any person or object from one photo into unlimited scenes and styles. You can now maintain strong character consistency in objects across your entire project, whether that's a marketing campaign, a children's book, or, you know, just having some fun. In this video, we'll explore what's new, how it works, and the ways you can transform your creative workflow. So here I am logged into Midjourney. In order to use the Omni Reference feature, all I need to do is just simply click on Add Images and I'll have this new Omni Reference box. Now I have a AI created image here of a woman holding a coffee mug and we're gonna call her Sarah. She is our de facto representative for our fictitious company, the Cloud Brew Coffee Company. So instead of having Sarah here standing in front of a wall, let's put her into a coffee shop. So in order to do that, I'm just going to tell Midjourney exactly that. And after waiting just a few seconds, we can now see Sarah is sitting in a coffee shop. Yay! We created our first image using Omni Reference. So the reality is here at the Cloud Brew Coffee Company is we need Sarah in a lot of different assets. And here's how you can leverage Omni Reference in order to achieve that. So first up, let's change Sarah's expression. I want to see some teeth in her smile here. So in order to do that, I'm just going to simply reuse my prompt and just add in the words, a beautiful smile. Amazing. Here's Sarah now with a nice warm smile that we can use in our Instagram feed. But what if this wasn't exactly the expression that we had in mind? Well, you can actually use Image Reference in tandem with Omni Reference to achieve that. So let's reuse our prompt, and I'll still use beautiful smile, but I'm going to bring in an additional photo I have of a person that has a nice warm smile. Here's where things will get tricky. Whenever using image prompts with Omni Reference, the image prompt can actually push the person, Sarah here in this case, to look more like our original image prompt. So we have to account for that. Now, in order to do that, you can do that one of two ways. You can either try increasing the Omni Reference strength, say up to about 250, and then generate the image and then review the results and see if that's close to what you had in mind. So let's take a look at that. Okay, this image is good, but it's not great. Sarah's got that nice warm smile from our image reference photo, but she's now sitting on a bed, not in a coffee shop. Again, we're selling coffee, not bed sheets. So how can we fix this? One of the best ways I can see to fix this is by using a more specific prompt. So here are some of our earlier images of Sarah. So I'm just going to right click on this one and click on describe. Basically, what I'm trying to do is expand on our prompt and be a little bit more specific to try to force Midjourney to create the appropriate image for our social media assets. So we can see here there are several prompts to choose from, but basically what I'm looking for is an image that describes Sarah specifically as well as the scene. So I like this one right away because it's quite longer and it's more specific about Sarah. So I'm going to prefer this one. Now, before I use this prompt, I'm just going to load our previous prompt into the Imagine bar here. And then we can see the image prompt and Omni Reference prompt are set. Then going to click on this prompt, and then it will automatically fill it all out. Now, I'm just going to make a few modifications to the prompt to try to really force Midjourney to get the image right. So first off, I'm going to say in the background is a barista and some customers. Then I'm just going to add in a couple of adjectives here, like a steamy cappuccino, along with just saying that she's sitting at a wooden table. All right, that looks good. So we can leave this aspect ratio flag here. However, though, if you wanted to make it a little bit different, you could. And then I'm going to add in an additional parameter, and that is the image weight parameter. So the image weight can vary anywhere between 0 and 3. The default value is 1. While we want to retain that warm smile from our image prompt, we don't want Sarah to be sitting on a bed again. So I'm going to tone this really far down to only 0.2, and our Omni strength is still at 250. Perfect. We now have a much closer image to what I was hoping for by using our image prompt along with the Omni reference. As you can see here, Sarah is now in a coffee shop again, And she's got a nice looking cappuccino in her hands. And it's something that we can now use on our brand assets for the Cloud Brew Coffee Company. Okay, let's say we wanted to change up this facial expression. Let's say Sarah hypothetically went to a competitor's coffee brand and got a really bad cup of cappuccino and she is livid. So how do we do that? We are going to reuse that, and instead of saying and smiling, we are going to say screaming with anger. And then for the image prompt, we'll remove this one, but take in one that is a little bit more dramatic. So here is an image of a woman screaming, and then generate that. Now we are leaving the same weight for the Omni reference at 250 and the image weight at 0.2. All we did was just made a few tweaks with the prompt and the image reference. And as we can see here, this will be the last time Sarah will ever go to a competitor's coffee shop. They must have some horrible tasting coffee. So that's facial expressions with Omni reference along with image prompts. So we covered Omni reference for character consistency. However, though, it's also really powerful whenever it comes to objects and styles. One thing that I discovered with Omni reference that I don't think a lot of people know about is its ability to transfer textures onto objects. So what do I mean by that? Let's jump over to Midjourney Explore. And I'm just going to search up colorful texture. And we see a whole long list of images that we can use. So I'm going to use this one just as an example and drag it to my Omni reference. And I'm going to leave the value at a default of 100. Now, I'm going to still stick to a coffee shop setting. So I'm just going to add my prompt really quickly here. So my prompt here is a photo of a woman sitting in a coffee shop. On the table is a colorful painted mug. And my hopes here is that the mug will take on that Omni reference image. So let's head back over to Create and wait for our image to appear. And as you can see, two of the four images have a nearly perfect transfer, these two in the center, of that Omni reference image onto the mug. Again, you can use this for many different things, but a really powerful tool whenever it comes to style and object transfer. Now, there are a few things that you should definitely know about Omni reference before you start to incorporate it into your workflow. So first up is the GPU time doubles within Midjourney. So you can really burn through your credits quite faster than if you were to use the version 6 model of a character reference. Secondly, you can't use it in the editor, so you can't use it to vary the region or zoom, in painting, out painting, and so on. So you're just stuck to create mode. I would imagine Midjourney would roll out Omni reference to the editor in the near future. It seems odd that it's not already included. Now, thirdly, I noticed is that small details for Omni reference don't always transfer, so prompting is very important here. Midjourney knows of the image in Omni reference, but you have to help describe it. And that's the purpose of the prompt. So be sure that you're always very specific in order to get the best results. And don't be afraid to alter the weights, especially when using style references. If you plan on using Omni reference along with style references, you really need to adjust those weights quite a bit in order to get the perfect results. So that's it with the Omni reference. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please drop it in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.